Hello.
Room
2.
Now I say, Konnichiwa. McFrozen Nugget here. Come to you with another video. Genki desu. And today, I'm going to be doing my second to last World Grand Prix Racer review on Shuto Hiroki, the Japanese racer from Cars 2. And in case you don't know what Konnichiwa and Ogenki desu mean, Konnichiwa basically means hello, and Ogenki desu, or Ogenki desu, means how are you today? Both of which I learned from iCarly's I Go to Japan. For those who watched that episode about iCarly, you know where I got it from. But yeah, again, this guy is the Japanese racer from Cars 2, being from Tokyo, Japan. And obviously, this is actually a little bit more special for me because it is basically where the birthplace of Kendo is from. Or rather, Japan is basically where the art of Kendo was born. Now, so heavily influenced the lightsaber duel in the classic 6 Star Wars movies. Especially the prequels, because of how fast-paced those duels got, because holy crap. By the way, prequels are the GOAT. I don't care what anyone says, they are awesome, and they should get a lot more respect than they have in the last 20-plus years. But yeah, anyway, let's take a look at the packaging of Shu here. And here is the packaging for Shu here. Now, obviously, this is the same as the previous two, being that of Nigel Gearsley and Rick Konchkonsky. But one thing that's different is that while this does have the same back overall design, having it split between the Cars logo and the actual character art, there is actually no divot or ridge in the packaging, because this was made earlier in 2018. So, of course, that means it was still made in China. Like, I'll show you rips, for example. See, like, right here, there's a ridge right here. Yeah, right there. You can see where the light is hitting it, that there's a ridge right there where the name tag is. This one does not have that. And again, right here, made in Thailand, made in China. Yeah, this one, China was still making the Cars diecast in their, or when Mattel was still making Cars diecast in China, but now they switched to both Thailand and Vietnam. But honestly, I think a lot of people would agree with me on this. We just like the China diecast the most, or a lot better, because the decals are the clearest, and yes, they have their issues, but They're just the best. Yeah, anyway. Now let's take a look at Shuto Hiroki himself. Now, obviously, this guy appeared in all the races in the World Grand Prix and Cars 2, plus the Rear Springs Grand Prix at the end of the movie. Like, I need to say that as per usual. And by the way, the reason why the lane is a little bit different here is because obviously he's a white car, and the, like, here, focusing on the carpet, and then focusing on Shu. Sorry. Yeah, it kind of darkens a little bit because he's a lot brighter compared to the others. Like, I use Lewis Hamilton, for example. Yeah, see, it brightens a little bit compared to the rug, because he's a much darker colored car. Where his shoe here, look at that. It's kind of similar to how, to be honest, it actually kind of reminds me of how RC Cars 5's iPhones actually kind of react fairly badly to blue cars, or even yellow cars, and it makes the line look all funky and whatnot. But for me, it's not really that bad. It's really just a slightly lighter in color car. And before I actually full-fledged get onto his review, his original release in 2011 was a little bit different than the one I have here. Right here, it has a black bumper. Whereas originally, when it was released in 2011, I actually show the back of Rip here. He originally had a white bumper. Now, granted, this is a prototype image, but if you actually have one of the original releases of, or older release of Shu, you would know that he originally had a white bumper, when in reality, that was actually inaccurate to the movie, because in the movie, he actually has a black bumper. And later on, Mattel actually corrected this in 2013, and they actually reissued, and they actually fixed that and gave him a black bumper instead to make it more movie accurate, which is something that I really, really liked. Al Mattel gets a lot of grief nowadays, considering the fact that they've really slacked on a lot of the diecasts. But you still gotta give them credit for some of the things that they fixed fairly early on. But anyway, let's get on to the review. He actually has a really determined expression compared to, like, say, Nigel Gearsley and Rip Plunjanski. Well, actually, Jeff Corvette, who I reviewed last year, he actually has a determined expression as well. But this one, he actually has kind of a frowning smirk instead of like a full-fledged, like, scowling face, like with Jeff here. See the difference right there. And to be honest, I kind of sort of don't completely understand why they made his eyelids gray, like a light gray. But it's not really too bad. I know it's obviously just so they wouldn't get confused with the main paint scheme or whatnot. Obviously, he has the Japanese characters on the hood with his number 7. And his headlights. Those are what's supposed to be his rearview mirrors, but they're not really painted. Ford Grand Prix number 7, powered by All in All. There are the Japanese characters again. He's got a War Grand Prix on the spoiler. And he actually has different sides, which I'll get to in a little bit. It's the back. It's taillights. And then this is the main part of him that makes him so cool. He's got the sort of dragon flame-esque design on, which makes him look so awesome. Just has that classic Japanese spirit. Especially when if this guy was, like, in anime-style drawing or art, if this guy was appeared in, like, an anime-style piece of art, I think he would look absolutely amazing, especially with that dragon design, that dragon flame design. Now, see, I know anime is really popular these days, so I wanted to kind of throw that in, because it's just something that I thought of when just looking at him. And here's the base. Again, he's made in China. And actually, the date stamp we can actually read nowadays, in case I haven't brought it up before. 0058 EAA, meaning that he was made in on the 5th day of 2018. So this is actually more, that actually seems to be more of a spring slash early summer 2018 release. Just before they made the switch to Thailand. And this guy actually got targeted by the laser camera in Puerto Corsa just after Carla Veloso. And basically triggered one of the, basically what DC Dark RC even said this is review of the canceled currently Shoot Hiroki with Flames diecast that he got 10 of. It basically kickstarted what may consider to be the saddest moment in the movie, because pretty much seven of the Wolverine pre-races behind McQueen and Francesco crashed, and the only two that can stop just in the nick of time were Jeff and Lewis. Now, obviously, it was because they had real-life voice actors that they're based on, being Jeff Gordon and Lewis Hamilton. But I think as far as canon goes, I think they just simply applied their brakes a lot harder and stopped a lot quicker. Now, maybe that's just me, but that's just what I thought of. Like, they saw the crash down. It's like, and they're like, oh crap! Whew! And in the back of their heads, they were happy that they were glad. They were probably glad they stopped just in time. But they were obviously horrified by the crash that happened. Obviously, blame Professor Z and Miles Axelrod for that. And excuse my language, fuck them. Yeah. Again, as with the case with all the other World Grand Prix racers, I don't have any other variations of them, so let's just, at the very least, pull up the others that I currently have. This is actually already the 10th World Grand Prix racer diecast that I have reviewed. The last one will be Miguel Camino. And then that'll be it for the World Grand Prix racers. So I might actually go back and get newer Francesco Bernoulli, and I can like do a proper review of him instead of just using the beat up one that I currently have from 2013. So yeah, as usual, social media links in the description below. Drop a like if you enjoyed this. And after Miguel Camino, see you on the other side of all the World Grand Prix racers. Love all you folks to death. And of course, don't forget to keep it rigid.